everyone's doing all right today. We have been thinking about people who met Jesus and the difference that that made in their lives, haven't we? Can you remember who some of them were? We found out about Zacchaeus and then the man who was lowered through the roof. We found out about when the children met Jesus, the woman at the well, and last time we found out about Nicodemus, who went out in secret and met Jesus in the night time. But who are we thinking about today? Shall we have a look in the Bible and find out? Come on then. Oh, what's this? Oh, I know what this is. It's one of those choosers, or some people call them a chatterbox, because they can chatter like this. And what you have to do, if you've never had one of these before, is you have to choose one of the numbers. So I'm going to choose number 2, and then you make it move 2 times like this. 1, 2. And then as you can see, there are some colours inside. So then you choose one of the colours, and I'm going to choose blue. And then you spell out the word blue. So then you go B-L-U-E. And then you look at the colours again and choose again. And this time I'm going to choose red. But you open it up and open up the flap that's got the red colour on it and read what it says inside. And inside there's a question. Oh, this is a really hard one. It says chocolate or crisps. Would you rather have chocolate or crisps? I'm definitely more of a chocolate person, so it'd be chocolate for me. But this is called a chooser because there are so many things to choose from inside. And in today's story from the Bible, we are going to meet somebody who had a really difficult thing to choose when he met Jesus. Shall we go and find out a bit more about that? Come on then. So, here is the story from the Bible for today. There was a rich man, a very rich man. I think he probably had expensive clothes, a beautiful house, lots and lots of servants, and lots of money. But there was one thing that the rich man wanted that he didn't already have, and that was that he wanted to be a friend of Jesus. One day, the rich man met Jesus and he was very, very excited. He told Jesus that he wanted to be his friend, and Jesus asked him some questions. I wonder if Jesus did that because he was just checking that the man really wanted to be a friend of his. So Jesus said to the man, "Have you been good? Have you been behaving well?" And the rich man said, "Yes, I have." And then Jesus said, "Do you try not to tell lies?" And the rich man says, "Oh, no, I don't tell lies." And Jesus said, "Do you try to do what your mum and dad asked you to do?" And the man said, yes, I do that. And then Jesus said, "Do you try to not take things that aren't yours?" And the rich man said, "No, I don't steal. No, that's all fine." So that all sounds good, doesn't it? But being a friend of Jesus isn't just about following the rules, is it? Then Jesus said, "There's one more thing I'd like you to do." And so the rich man says, "Yes, what is it?" And Jesus said, "What I want you to do is I want you to sell your expensive clothes and your beautiful house and get rid of your servants and give all of the money away to people who need it more than you do. And then come and be my friend." How exciting! It seems as if the man was already trying to live God's way, apart from this one thing. I wonder if the man really wanted to be friends with Jesus, or if the man was really wanting to be friends with his money more than he wanted to be friends with Jesus. But to be friends with Jesus is so amazing, much more amazing than nice clothes and a beautiful house and servants or money. What do you think the man did? Of course, the man gave everything away and sold everything and gave all his money to people who didn't have very much. actually. No, he didn't. He liked his expensive clothes and his beautiful house and his servants and his money. He didn't want to lose them, and he thought they were more important than being friends with Jesus. So do you know what he did? He walked away from Jesus and chose not to be his friend. And that made Jesus really sad, because he wants to be friends with everyone, but will always let people make that choice for themselves. I don't think that Jesus was saying that it's wrong to have expensive clothes or a beautiful house or servants or money. But I think he was asking the man if all of that was more important than being friends with Jesus. So when the rich man met Jesus, he found out that Jesus wants everyone to be his friend, but that he asks us to think about what is the most important thing in our lives. The rich man chose his money to be the most important thing. Now it's time to make our own chooser. So shall we go and find out how? Come on then. Here is what we're making today. You will need some scissors, some felt tip pens and some paper. And the first thing we need to do is change our rectangle paper into some square paper. So you line up this edge to this edge, folding here. Cut this strip off. And there's our square. We have a line going right the way down the middle, but we need one to go across as well. So we fold it up this way. And now we need to make a star shape with the line. So we're going to fold it this way and this way. And there's our star shape. Next, we need to take this point right over to the middle and fold it there. And keep going all the way around. Turn the whole thing over and do it again. So lining up with this point into the middle and folding. Make sure all the folds are nice and crisp. Now fold it this way and open it up. Turn it round and fold it this way and open it up. Turn the whole thing over and make sure you've got these pockets there, because that is where your fingers and thumbs are going to go to make your chooser. All ready to decorate. There are my thumbs and there are my fingers. Make sure you've got it on the side with the squares facing up, and then you can choose what you want to do on yours. The one I showed you earlier had numbers on the top bit, but this one I'm going to choose colours. Now turn it over and see if you can find the triangles. There are 8 of these altogether, so you can choose what to put on these now, colours or numbers. You can
could even put animals on them, anything you like, but I'm going to do numbers. There we are. Open up one of the flaps inside, you'll find two more triangles, and on each of these ones you need to write your question to see what the person you're playing with will choose. And on this one I'm going to write, would you rather have chocolate or chips? Fill up all the other triangles with your questions. Now carefully get it back into shape again. And remember, it's your fingers and thumbs going in. Get it into the right shape. And there it is. What will your one look like?
Well, that's it for Buzz Club today, and I hope that you have fun playing with your chooser. And don't forget, you can put anything on yours at all. That's also it for Buzz Club for now, because it's the summer holidays coming up and we have got All Sorts Holiday Club at home. It's going to be brilliant. We've got games and crafts and songs and lots of stories from the Bible as well. So if you keep an eye on our website and on Facebook and keep an eye out for an announcement coming up all about it, we hope that you will be able to join us there too. But for now, I'm going to say goodbye.